For joining us. We hope that you enjoyed watching that package about dwarfism and, you know, some of the challenges that come with living in such situations. At the end of the day, these are amazing people. They're normal. There's nothing absolutely wrong with them. So please be a little kinder to those around you, those who know, you know, that are going through such challenges. Now it's time for us to have our celebrity guest in the studio with us. This is one of my favorite people because I like her positive energy and her vibe. She's an on-air personality, TV presenter, radio presenter, brand influencer, and she is your fave TV girl. Her name is Tomika Adeoye. The moment somebody saw that Tomika was coming on my show today, they said, two of you.
I know, right?
How are you,
Tomika? I'm fine, thank you.
You're always happy. You are a burst of sunshine. Aww. You're a bubble of energy. People meet you, and they just like you. So I said to someone that if anybody meets Tomika and doesn't like Tomika, the problem is not with the person. The problem is not with Tomika.
It's with the person.
What gives you this drive, you know, that keeps you constantly happy all the time?
I really don't know, to be honest. I can't even explain it. It was recently when I noticed, like, so many people keep asking me questions about, oh, why do you remain this happy? And then I search within and try to find the reason. And I realized there's really no reason, but the fact that I constantly remind myself that there are things that I have to be grateful for. I mean, as much as we get carried away with life and so many things we're looking for, you just realize there's always something to smile about. If it's not a video on social media, you would always find something to keep you happy, really. So I don't know. And it's easier to be happy than to be sad.
But I'm definitely sure that beyond what we see on social media, there are days that you're sad. So I know that Tomika is a town crier. You're always crying. You know, Tomika is happy, she cries. She's sad, she cries.
So
give us an insight into the moments we don't get to see, those sad moments that we don't get to see. What's it like?
There was one that happened. It's funny how I don't even share this often, but you asked me now, so I'm just going to share. Just so that people know that really there are times that it's not always so great. This happened 2 days ago. I had, like, I think 3 events back to back. And then on the final day, I had to get up so early again to go to work. Like, my legs were aching because I was standing literally the entire day and everything. And as soon as I got up, it felt like I wanted to die. And then I just told my husband, please, just my leg, help me massage it. And then he massaged it. And I was like, would it be bad if I just call everybody and say, I'm not doing it again? Said, no, but you know you have to go. So I just got up. And you wouldn't believe that. I don't know, the pains that I felt when I got up and I went to have my bath. And as soon as I entered the bathroom, I just started crying. Like, I don't even know how I felt. Like, I was literally in tears. And then I was trying not to let him know that I was crying, but I was just crying like, God, I'm just so tired this morning. And then he just walked in like, what would... The look on his face was priceless. Like, did you fall down? What happened? And I'm just so tired. My body is paining me. Hurry up. And then, I don't know, as soon as I took that shower, I just seeing him pet me, I just felt like, yeah, now let's do this.
Let's continue. You know, so just so that people get to see that not all that you see on social media is exactly how it happens, that even the happiest of people get sad too sometimes.
Yes, they do,
because some people will measure their level of happiness with yours and think, oh, why am I not happy? Tomika is always happy.
Nah.
And on the days where somebody meets you and, you know, they meet you on a bad day, they should be able to make exceptions and make excuses
for you
and say, you know, Tomika is not always like this.
Yeah.
So please understand that people are human beings. I'm going to make reference to the Pamela Ray and Peruzzi story shortly. But,
okay, no problem.
You know, everybody has something nice to say about you.
Aww.
Have there been times when you've seen some negative comments?
Yes.
What would you say is like the worst thing or some of the worst things you've seen, and how does it make you feel?
I don't know. It just makes me feel like people are mad. That's really what I'm going to describe it. I mean, there was a day I went to a particular organization and I was so friendly with them, even from I'm that kind of person that as soon as I walk in from security, I start smiling and saying hello because I don't even know what you've gone through that day. So I try to, like, bring my positive vibes into your life and just make you feel special. And I took that same energy to that organization. You know, we had some things to do and everything. And I left that organization not knowing that they had bad things to say about me.
Oh, wow.
And I can't find where the bad things came from. And then they were speaking to someone I knew and they were like, oh, that Tomika girl, I don't even like her. I mean, the vibe she puts on social media is not the vibe she brought to the office. And I'm like, which other vibe are you searching for? Please tell me. Which vibe again? And I'm like, are you joking? I was smiling with these guys like that. I was so exhausted, but, you know, I was still laughing to their gist and everything. And all they had to say was, she's different from how she is. And I'm like, oh, that queen, corrupt. And, you know, another person was telling a friend of mine, was like, ah, That Tomike, you know, she shouts too much. You should tell her to keep it calm on social media because it's not good for her brand. And I'm like, my brand or your brand?
The brand that has been giving you money.
I know,
brand,
right?
Paying your bills.
Like,
when
how?
You get these comments, Tomike, where people try to tell you stuff like, oh, you're shouting too much, or you are too friendly, or calm down, does that affect you emotionally? Does it sometimes make you feel like, you know, question yourself?
To be honest, yes, because I try to, as much as possible, like when people criticize you, to search if there are facts and truths in things that they are saying, because to be honest, there might be element of truth in it. So I just try to, you know, filter it and say, okay, is this possible? Am I doing something wrong? But then I know who I am. I know that what I am in real life is the person I am on social media. Like I'm very, very over the top and all that. So I'm like, okay, I really can't be changing myself for people. So I just pick the ones that might be for me, but every other thing that I check myself and then I check the comments and I'm like, nah, nah, nah. But I've reached that point where it doesn't really get to me. I'm like, eh, they'll be all right.
At the end of the day, they'll be all right.
So. You know, so basically.
You were not always this, I mean, you were once a Tomike Alayon, then now you're Tomike Adeoye.
Hey,
we will
like,
come
play,
to
like,
that
play.
Story shortly. But you were not always this fave TV girl that everybody loved.
I know,
you
right?
had a journey, you had a process. So how did it all begin?
It all began in university. I attended the University of Lagos. I was studying microbiology. And then in my year two, I just realized that, no, I knew since secondary school, but when I realized in secondary school, it was literally too late for me to switch to, you know, mass communication because I was already in science class. So I just said, okay, let me follow through till the end. And then when I got into uni, you know, everybody's always putting that pressure. You have to get into school. So I couldn't be changing courses at that dying minute. So when I began to study microbiology my second year, I went to Inlag FM, I auditioned, and then I was a volunteer till I was done with school. Like, I wasn't literally making money from there, but I was just enjoying, you know, go on air, talk to people, know that people are listening to me. And that was how the radio journey began for me. And then from there, I got referrals from the radio station for some TV jobs as well. And then that was how TV started. And then from there, I picked up social media. I'm the kind of person that I kind of like people to, let me just say, the Kim Kardashian kind of life. Not really about showing everything, but just letting people see what's going on in my life. Like, I feel like there's always a story to share. And that's when I began to make good use of my social media. And I'm like, oh, people are enjoying these things. Like, when people see you and feel like, oh, they are connected to you. Obviously, it's not everything I put out there. Like, the day I woke up and I was crying, you did
nobody
not see
that. Exactly.
Yeah, so you literally just filter your content and everything. And I'm like, ah, there's money in this thing too. And, you know, the influencing started because, you know, you have to dress up and go to work. You know our life now.
Exactly.
Dress up, do makeup, hair, flick, everything, and take pictures. And then I realized, oh, brands were coming. Oh, I want you to wear my clothes. I want you to be like, oh, yeah, bring money. I wear your clothes. Don't worry. You don't have to pay a model. And I realized it was another source of income as well. So literally, that's the summary of how the journey began. And along the way, I featured in Jennifer's Diary when I was in school because I went for the audition and then acting. I'm like, I go back. No, just
so
join
you
it.
So you are a multifaceted person.
Kind
and,
of.
You know, you're a radio TV actor, influencer. But I still want to talk about your TV journey. I know that you currently host the WWNW show on Ebony Live TV. Mm-hmm. And you're also a host for VVIP events. Mm-hmm. How did you get into that TV space, that Ebony Live space, like your audition? Can you relieve the memories? Now, this is because there are many people who want to one day audition for a TV show or, mm-hmm. you know, and they want to become TV presenters like you, but they're wondering, how did she do it? How would I get my own shot? And the day that they get their shot, they need to be ready. Were
exactly.
you ready the day you got your opportunity?
To be honest, I was very ready, and I think I was overly ready, and that even affected me to some point. Yes, you always have to be ready. As much as I tell people, like, oh, okay, you're trying to go into TV and everything, what are you doing in the little space that you have? I mean, you could literally hold your phone and do anything. Like, you can create an imaginary show and present, literally, to train yourself for when the opportunity comes. But thankfully, I was doing radio already. My friend in the UK sent me the audition for Ebony Live TV for the competition. And then, you know, I auditioned for it. And I got there and they were saying I was too mature. And they needed... Because I was already on TV. And presenting shows for adults and all that. And then they wanted, like, youngsters, like 16 and everything. And I went for the competition the week before my final year exam. So it was literally tough. But thankfully, my family members and everyone was so supportive. Because everyone was like, do you have sense at all? Go and finish your microbiology before you start going for competitions. But thankfully, I was able to couple both of them together. And the last week, the last day of the show, you know, they were to send three people. We're six left. They were to send three people home and retain three. And they were already like, oh, Tomike, you are too mature, blah, blah, blah. And then, thankfully, they did not send me home. Like, there were only three of us that were not on the couch, like the personalities that they wanted. They created segments to suit our personalities. Oh, and so they created like a celebrity tracker segment. And, okay, since you are mature, you can handle celebrities on the red carpet. They gave me that segment. Oh. And that was how it happened. And from there, I began hosting VVIP events as well. And then the WW and W show. So literally, TV has been fun, Sha.
Now, if you have to choose of all the various things that you do, you're a TV presenter and on-air personality on radio, you're an actor, you're a brand influencer. If we had to make you to choose just one, which would be the first one that will come to your mind without thinking?
Brand influencer.
Totally care.
Oh my, that life is sweet.
So what is sweet about being a brand influencer?
The fact that you get to create content that suits your personality, like you literally don't have to go out of your comfort zone because you realize these people are coming to you because of your personality. Basically. And so it's just like infusing their brands into your personality. And I really, really enjoy it. And the pay is
okay,
good.
So now let's talk about the fundamentals of being a brand influencer. Mm-hmm. Because it's some sort of extra income that lots of young people are veering into. What would you say to someone who's wanted to be a brand influencer, but they don't know how to go about it because they probably have like 300 Instagram followers and they're looking to build their followership? Your followership increased right before my eyes. It was like wildfire. 1 minute, I was more than your follower. And all of a sudden, like, where is this girl running to? What's going on?
Oh, like, my goodness.
You know, so your followers have increased like wildfire. And we've seen your growth, and it's so beautiful to watch.
Oh, thank
but what
you.
Would you say to some other young girl who has little followers? She has maybe 300, 400, 500, or a young man, but wants to go into brand influencing. What would be some of the tips that you would give to them?
First things first, you shouldn't be too desperate. I mean, many of us that are into this influencing thing, which you are as well, you'd realize it's something that actually came along the way. We didn't, you know, venture into social media with the mindset of being an influencer. You know, I was just taking pictures, posting good pictures, making videos for people, like going all out. I'm the kind of person that if you send me an item, I just really want the world to know how good it is. If it's a very good item, not because you are paying me for it, but because I just want to share. I mean, you know how, what I said about me wanting people to see like an inside of what goes on in my life. I just feel, oh, if your thing is good, everybody should know about it. They should patronize you. And that was something that I already did on a norm. And then when I realized, oh, there was money to this thing, I added it on board. So really, you shouldn't go into it being so desperate for the money. It should be something that comes naturally, basically. And as much as, yes, you want to have followers and all that, build yourself, build your brand, build your social media page. If you go into it for the money, trust me, you might not last long in it, because it's not every time that it's all rosy and sweet. Once another person comes like this, they can almost forget you, and you know,
I mean,
you have to stay relevant. Exactly. So you have to stay very relevant. So start from now in your own little space. Take pictures, good pictures, by the way. You don't have to own like the biggest phone or the most expensive phone to, you know, build your page and your brand.
Let's talk about brand influencing. When what you consider quality is in conflict with what the client brings. So somebody brings you an outfit, you know the outfit quality isn't great, but they are paying you to promote it.
To be honest, I don't do it. I mean, because at the end of the day, it rubs off on my brand. If someone goes there and purchases it, they'll be like, oh, Tomika recommended you, but look at the rubbish you made. It's literally tainting my image to some extent. It's tainting my image. And I've come to realize that many people just want to push things on you because they know they're going to get followers or they're going to get people to buy their brand. I still sent an email 2 days ago or 3 days ago. The lady sent me items and she had even paid before, because like the invoice always has my account details, and she had paid before we spoke about the item and all that. And she sent me pictures of the clothes, and I'm like, oh, are there more options? I really don't like this item. It doesn't suit my brand. And she's like, okay, no problem. We can speak about it, or maybe I create one that suits your personality. And I feel like it's not so hard. If it's too hard and she's not getting it, I will send her money back. Like, it's not that deep, really. Like, that's why I said you shouldn't be too desperate, because if you're so desperate, you end up probably taking that clothes, and some people will be like, so you can't even wear this type of clothes. It will really affect your brand. So really, I don't do things for the money, even especially brands that I don't like. At times, I run away from that email. Please forgive me. I'm not... I mean, there's some people that would not just reply, because I don't want to spoil, like, I don't want to ruin your mood and say no. Do you understand? So there are some emails that I actually run from because I don't like those brands. And I feel like many people need to work more on their brand before you start going about, oh, I want to, you know, publicize, or I want to use an influencer. Work on your brand, ensure that it's the best quality. So really, I don't mind saying no. It's not always about the money. It's about my brand at the end of the day.
Fantastic. She doesn't mind saying no. And you shouldn't mind saying no to no. You know, I saw a quote someone that said, no is a complete sentence. And I loved it. Like, you don't have to explain why. No. No explanation.
No. It's a no.
So, Mickey, let's talk about you as an actor. What would you say that being on Jennifer's Diary did to your brand? I mean, you predicted your wedding in Jennifer's Diary.
I know, right? No, I think it was the other movie, Amendable. Okay. I don't know how it happened. And you know, people were sending me the video before my wedding, and after the wedding, they sent me the videos. And I used to look at you saying you want your wedding to be all over the place. It was actually all over.
Your wedding was all over the place.
Yes, it was actually. Acting is something that is interesting for me, but it's so time consuming. You know how you can be on set from morning till night.
And still not shoot.
Thank you. That's it.
Thank you.
No, it's crazy. It's not easy. That's why you don't see me on so many movies and so many series, because it's really time consuming. But then I wouldn't mind. It's not bad.
So being on Jennifer's Diary, what did it do to your brand?
To be honest, it's really helped me. I won't lie. I mean, so many people saw me in a whole different light. And you know, everyone loves Jennifer's Diary. Like, the fan base is crazy. So even when I was in school back then, you know, you'd be walking, Tanya, is that not you? But you know, one thing I realize now is that so many people don't even know I was that girl in Jennifer's Diary. Because, you know, I've talked to a fine girl, make up for Flea,
girl, Flea. She has turned to a fine girl. What are you saying? You've always been a babe.
No, that time, Olive, you know how it is in school now.
By the end of the day, you're evolving.
Exactly.
And you have evolved from one stage to another. Yes, you know, I mean, you have a rock on your finger. And you're no more Tomike Adeoye like I knew you or like I met you. You're now Tomike Alayode. You're
like, now Tomike Adeoye. You don't carry your sister and go.
I
like,
know. Like... So, first of all, how would you say that being married has, you know, how has it changed your life? Have there been any changes?
I think I'm more responsible. I mean, I'm sure my mom will be looking at me like, she said it, the last time she came to the house, she was like, so you can't cook like this. And in the house, you will not even be useful for me, but you can be useful like this. I think I am more responsible. You know, I feel like, oh, my husband is my responsibility. Like, if I'm at home before him, he should come back and make food at home. Like, I just have that sense of responsibility. Like, I have somebody to take care of. That's the only thing that I feel has changed about me. I think I am more responsible. Like, I know that, oh, you have to do that. There's nobody that's going to do it for you and all that. So instead of being the sports child that I used to be, I'm more responsible. I cook now.
But you weren't cooking before you got married.
I wasn't really cooking because you know how this our job is now. And now I realized that. So I could have been cooking then. Because even still, I'm very busy, but I still find time to cook.
And you seem to really enjoy it.
I do.
Every time on Insta Story, you're giving us cooking classes. I mean, the last one was you taught us how to make ogbono soup.
So. I actually enjoy it. You know, the thing I like about it is just seeing the appreciation on his face every time I feed him. I don't know. That gives me so much joy. I mean, that encourages me to cook. You know, just him saying, oh, I will wait till I get home to eat. It's just like, you gotta cook, girl. It's just like me showing myself to him. I don't know, it's just fun. Married life is beautiful. And I realize in this day and age, many people carry marriages on their head. And I just think marriage should be whatever you want it to be. You shouldn't let anybody's marriage define you. Same as my wedding day. I mean, many people were saying, you were so different. You were all over the place. You were this, you were that. I'm like, it's my day. Like, as much as you want to be, I'm the bride. It's not that deep at the end of the day.
People criticize you at any point, you know, because I know during your wedding, you did Instagram live on your traditional wedding day. And that's because you have a community of followers that were telling you, Tomike, some of us are abroad and we want to keep, abreast of what's going on at your wedding. Did you get people criticizing
Yes.
you?
I still had a friend call me 2 weeks ago saying, another friend of ours was saying, that your Tomike friend, how would she even hold her phone on her wedding day? How would she go live? And I'm like, is it your wedding? Was it you that got married? Girl. Was my husband complaining? Like, it's not that deep. And even in terms of marriage, I realize many young people are scared to get married because they feel their life is going to change. If you're in it with the right person, trust me, it's just going to be the normal life that you have. So please don't be scared and don't carry marriage on your head. I think wives also have a place to play in this role. Have a role to play in this part. Yes. Because you know, now when you're married, you're not be like, I'm sorry, I can't come out. My husband said this. My husband said, it's not that deep. Now marriage, you marry. You know?
You're
not a cute person. Exactly. So really, life is still the same.
Fantastic, Tomike. It's been an absolute delight speaking with you and just going, seeing all that happens behind the scenes.
Is this where you tell me goodbye?
This is where...
I can't go. We are just getting started.
Goodbye.
You want to leave me?
But, Tomike, I cannot leave you.
You can't tell
my
me to be going.
Sister, I can't leave you.
You can't tell me
but
to go.
But before I let you go, Tomike, last year you were nominated for the Future Awards TV presenter.
Which you collected and you are here to remind me. Really?
No,
who does that?
Tomike. Wow, just have mercy on me. You are my set today.
You are doing your job.
When I come to your set, you cannot finish me.
You are doing your job. Okay, no problem.
Exactly. So, you know, you
I'm still going to kill you.
Sorry, guys. Tomike, how did getting nominated make you feel?
It made me
feel...
It was
your first nomination. You should be loyal to your elders.
I'm sorry, mommy.
I was nominated before. It was my second nomination.
Okay. Sorry. You can have it.
All right. Thank you so much.
Well, you felt so good, really. I felt really excited. I didn't see it coming because, really, I know that you, my seniors, you're plenty in that market.
Seniors.
So... It was really good. I mean, I had so many people congratulating me, and I'm like, you're bad, though.
And you have so much love on social media. Your followers, you call them your family. It's like a little cult, people who are dedicated to you. And I want to give you this opportunity to say something, say to your followers how they make you feel. Because I see the love that you get, and I think it's absolutely mind-blowing. Aww. So I'd like to give you this opportunity to give a shout-out to your followers.
See, now you have made my eyes wet.
She has been crying. Crying.
My goodness, just talking about them just makes me so emotional. I'm not crying. My goodness, I love you guys so much. Like, you guys make it worth the stress, worth the pain, worth everything. Like, my social media, like, you guys are family. Like, you go all out for me. You take time to comment. It's not every time you see a picture that you want to type under. But, you know, you guys still type. You send me DMs. As much as I don't even have time to reply those DMs, you will still keep sending. And, you know, even sharing testimonies, sharing so many things. It really makes me feel special. And I feel like you're a huge part of my life. Like, without you, I would not have... over 100,000 followers. So you guys make me what I am today, and I'm just so happy that you remain glued to my page, and I love you so much.
Oh, this is so sweet. And I just want to give a special shout out to you. Oh, before I let you go, your husband. No, you have to give a shout out to your husband.
Ah, my boo. Baby, thank you so much for all that you do. Thank you for putting up with me. Thank you for marrying me. Thank you for making me your wife. I love you so much. Thank you for always encouraging me. Thank you for always spoiling me. I'm not gonna cry. I love you.
Okay.
I'll see you at home soon.
There's too much onions being cut in my studio, like we like to say here in Nigeria, because it's getting really emotional. I've had the pleasure of speaking with Tomike Alaya, the TV personality, brand influencer, actor, and MC. We touched on almost everything, except the MCing bit. Because there's just too much
to talk about you.
But
thank you.
It is an amazing, you know, it's been an amazing conversation. Thank you so much for gracing my set. And I wish you all the best. Your future is so bright and beautiful.
Amen. I receive it.
All that, you know, lies ahead of you.
Thank you.
Please follow Tomike on Instagram at Tomike_A. Show her some love. Follow her and she'll make you fishers of men.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.